So,
I wouldn't be
how
able
did you in these tough times, how did you keep both yourself and him motivated through this? Because
to keep
it was
myself,
really
sorry.
tough. Yourself and Farid both, how did you keep you both motivated?
During the lockdown, you mean? No, the motivation is overrated. Okay, I don't believe that you get motivation and then you act. You think that motivation causes action? No, it's wrong. I've learned it from a book called So Good They Can't Ignore You by Cal Newport. And he says that that's not true. Motivation doesn't cause action, it's the other way around. Action causes motivation. Yeah,
I like
the other way around.
that. I
Yeah,
like that.
action may not be big, it could be small, it could be big, it could be right, it could be wrong. You need to get started. That's all. And when you get started, law of inertia comes in place and you get into the flow. No, ideas don't come in fully formed. They only get clear when you work on them.
I
So
agree with
all you
you.
have to do is just get started. Yeah. I'll give you a simple example. When do you feel great and enthusiastic? While going to the gym from home or while coming back from the
Welcome.
gym? While coming back? Yeah. Why? Why? Because you have already taken some action and that motivates you to go to the gym on the next day. Right?
I agree.
So that action motivates to take more action. Yeah. Now another proof. If you fail to go to the gym today, there is a high chance I will not show up in the gym for 2 3 days. Aisa hota hai? There are a series of days we don't show up in the gym. Why? When I fail to take action today, that inaction demotivates me to take action tomorrow.
True
Action
that,
leads
true
to
that.
action, more action. Inaction leads to more inaction. It's simple.
That is
So
true.
I
That is
believe in
true.
action. I don't believe in thinking. Thinking is not action. Googling is not action. Okay. Yeah. Action is about, in my case, recording a summary, making a summary, talking to Farid about the next innovation in booklet app. These are actions. Yeah. So as I said, and there's one more extension to this, a corollary to this idea, is that positive actions lead to more positive actions and negative actions lead to more negative actions. If the
True
first thing when I wake up in the morning at 5 o'clock, if
that.
I just take my mobile and scroll news feeds of Instagram, which is a negative action, it's aimless action, there is a fair chance I'll be binge watching Netflix for the rest of the day or watch Kapil
True
Sharma for hours on YouTube. Yeah, but
that.
if the first thing I do when I wake up in the morning is go to the terrace and do some 100 push-ups, there is a fair chance that this positive action will lead me to more positive actions. Maybe I'll read a book, I'll meditate, I'll cook, I'll make summaries. Yeah, so it's very important that you start with a positive action at the very beginning of the day. And
That
I
makes
see now
sense.
a person who is down with 3 bottles of beer will never feel like eating an apple after that, right? He always feels
That is true.
eating something masala, oily, unhealthy. Why? Negative action cannot lead him to a positive action.